for me as an architect, the most interesting thing is to experiment with new materials and to play with light and space. One of the projects that we're really excited about is the Hardrock Cafe in Bangkok.
Hardrock Cafe is a worldwide known brand, but however, we want to look different. So the brief to the architect is that we need to have a unique design.
For the first concept of the Hardrock Cafe, we studied about what Hardrock really means as a brand. And what we think that most people think about Hardrock is really about the music. The way we did that was to actually sample some of the sound waves, just like musicians would do when they create the music as well. After sampling the sound waves, we were able to create a complex surface, but instead of creating one large surface, we want to break it up into small pieces in order to make a more dynamic facade. As a result, we created about over 2,000 panels that were angled at all different locations of the facade. When we finally developed this design, we presented it to the clients. We were quite confident that they were convinced that the design is great. But the question is, how do we make it in a way that we can really express the liveliness and the dynamic feeling that we wanted to go back to the main concept, which was about the music. For this project, we had a chance to study a lot of different materials, from stone to plastic and fibre-cement, from quite a lot of different companies and providers as well. The criteria that we need was the ability to support over 2,000 pieces of the facade. The weight of the construction is a very important factor in this particular design. And also a special effect of the color and the unique glossy finish that can reflect the light both day and night. The three main criteria for us was, first of all, to be able to overcome all the technical challenges for such a customized design. Secondly, to minimize the impact on the environment. And thirdly, to also fine-tune the design such that in the actual final result, that it would match our aesthetic goals as well. Finally, we were able to select this material because I think it met all three of our design criteria.
We were very surprised also to learn that SHERA ply is able to translate what we want into reality. With that, I have the confidence to use SHERA ply.
SHERA ply is a fibre cement product, which really helps it to make it very durable and suitable for exterior use. And in addition, it's able to receive different types of finishes and coatings, such as polyurethane, which is able to really change the behavior and the expression to suit the need of the design. With respect to environmental concern, I think SHERA ply does have one interesting thing, which is that it can be used as a suitable alternative to wood or stone and other natural resources. The technical issues was definitely very big in this project. SHERA ply is an interesting solution because it's on the one hand very durable and strong as a fibre cement product, but at the same time, it's a little bit lighter weight than maybe most of the products. I think this was what was unique about this SHERA ply compared to other materials.
The feedback generally is very good. At various angles, if you stand in the car park, it looks different because of the reflection of the SHERA ply and also the wave created by it. If you look at the building during sunset and during sunrise, it's a totally different building. So we are very happy with the effect that the SHERA ply is able to give to us.
I think finally, creativity is about looking at normal or everyday situations and things, but to look at it in new and creative ways.